The story of OneEye2017U1, or Oumuamua, seems to grow stranger at every passing turn. Not only is the object the first detected interstellar visitor to our solar system, it's also turning out to be very puzzling, to the point that some are suggesting that it may be of alien origin. Though that possibility is not well accepted, it's just a possibility, and it's overwhelmingly likely to be of natural origin. At the heart of this is the apparent acceleration of Oumuamua as it left the solar system. To put that in context, Oumuamua simply didn't slow down as much as one would expect during its encounter with the sun. It's not as if it's dramatically sped up, it hasn't. One possibility to create such an acceleration is that the object is actually a comet, and outgassing while it passed through the solar system simply gave it a push. Had this been observed, it would have been case closed, it was an exocomet. But this outgassing was not observed, and other recent modeling suggests that Oumuamua is not quite like a comet. It's also possible, however, that the outgassing was slow, or happened when we couldn't see it. But if outgassing wasn't to blame, then what was? In a paper by Shmuel Bialy and Abraham Loeb, they detail that light pressure from the sun could create the observed acceleration if the object had a certain geometry and low mass. They also point out that had the object been an outgassing comet, changes in Oumuamua's spin should have been observed. There were no such changes. They go on to detail that the object's behavior could be consistent with a light sail of some type. This does not immediately mean artificial, however. The authors detail that to account for the acceleration, the object would need to be extremely thin. The authors looked at whether such a thin object could survive long-distance travel across to interstellar space, along with the mechanical restraints it would be subject to. They found that such an object could survive for a substantial period of time, yet be less than a millimeter thick. So if the object is acting as a solar sail, it would need to be a very thin sheet of material. If that turned out to be the case, then what created it? That would be a scientific mystery indeed. If it's a natural object, there would need to be some natural process that could create something like that in a protoplanetary disk or other such conditions. But we know from geology on Earth, all sorts of strange things can happen to rocks. For example, one form of volcanic rock, known as Pele's Hair, is just such a case. It's possible for nature to stretch molten lava into seemingly impossible hair-like strands. Yet, it commonly happens. What could happen out in the universe is anyone's guess. But there is another very remote possibility presented in the paper, that Oumuamua could be artificial, and might represent an active or dead probe or simply someone's trash. There are two things detailed that seem to support this. Firstly, if you assume that Oumuamua is just a natural object randomly passing through the solar system, it may be that the production of such random objects in the galaxy exceeds what we see from our own solar system for most other stars by a factor of 100 million times or more. That seems surprising, but not impossible. But there's another aspect. The way the object entered the solar system and passed within a quarter of an AU of the sun put it on a good intercept course with Earth, which had passed by at just 0.15 astronomical units. Again, that it took a trajectory that might be a reasonable one for an alien probe wishing to check out Earth is a little odd, but this too could simply be random chance. And what's not well explained is the changes in brightness that were observed with Oumuamua. It appeared to be tumbling, and it seems to me that a light sail wouldn't work very well if it were doing that. The bottom line is that this is only a remote possibility, and that Oumuamua is probably just an odd type of asteroid or comet that we haven't seen before. And also worth noting is that so little is known about Oumuamua that more information may come to light that takes an artificial origin instantly off the table for the object. We just have to wait and see. But the fact remains, even as a natural object, Oumuamua is very weird and represents a new class of natural object we've never seen before. Unfortunately, it could also turn out that we may never have a definitive answer as to just what Oumuamua was, natural or not, as it is speeding away from us, and it doesn't seem likely we will realistically ever be able to intercept it, except perhaps in the far future. Also, as an aside, last night I briefly spoke with Dr. Loeb, and we had a conversation about this paper. You can hear that interview on my other channel, Event Horizon, link below, and coming soon will be a full interview with Dr. Karen Meach, one of the scientists investigating Oumuamua at the University of Hawaii. Do check them out. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently worried about Oumuamua turning around and coming back. What if something about human civilization enticed Oumuamua to drop by, and then it didn't find it during its first pass because it isn't always present on this world? Could we wake up to it EMPing us back into the Stone Age while broadcasting only one message over and over? Where McRib? What a regrettable end to human civilization. And on that note, be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.